Welcome to Final Cut Pro 10 in under 5 minutes. I'm Steve from RippleTraining.com. In this episode, we're going to take a look at what's new in Final Cut Pro 10.1.4, specifically how to import and export MXF files. Before getting into the workflow, it's important to define what MXF is, mainly because many cameras from Sony, Panasonic, and Canon record in this format. MXF is shorthand for Material Exchange Format, an industry-standard file wrapper similar to QuickTime that stores video and audio content and its associated metadata. Previous to version 10.1.4, you could import MXF files from supported cameras. However, what you could not do was import MXF files created from another editing application, like Avid's Media Composer, or import MXF files that came from a media archive system, like CatDV, or MXF Server. But perhaps most significantly, MXF files that have been copied from the native file hierarchy of the camera's media card could not be imported without first converting them using a third-party conversion utility. And even then, valuable clip metadata would often be lost. After installing the Final Cut Pro 10.1.4 update, you'll need to download and install the Pro Video Formats 2.0 update available on the App Store. You'll then be able to import MXF files from any source while preserving the metadata. Let's take a look. Here, I've launched the import window, and I've navigated to some MXF files on an asset management server. Notice that the files use an MXF extension as opposed to the MOV extension. Of particular interest for news producers, Final Cut Pro now supports Panasonic's AVC Ultra Long G format. Once imported, you can view the metadata by selecting the clip, opening the inspector, and clicking the Info button. From the Metadata Views menu, choose Extended to reveal the frame rate, timecode, codec, audio configuration, and other useful metadata. To view specific MXF metadata, choose Edit Metadata View, then select the MXF metadata options you want displayed from this list. If you work with MXF files frequently, it's a good idea to save your metadata view as a custom set by clicking the gear menu and choosing Save Metadata View As, then giving your metadata view a descriptive name. I'll call this one MXF, then click OK. You'll need to reselect the clip in the browser to refresh the inspector and update the view. Here we see all the MXF metadata I saved with a custom view. If you plan on sending your MXF files and projects to a third-party application for finishing, broadcasting, or archiving into a media database, the best option for preserving the metadata is XML. With a clip or project selected, choose Export XML from the File menu, then choose the custom metadata set you want included in your XML file from this pop-up. Saving the best for last, Apple has now given us a complete MXF post-production pipeline, as it's now possible to export MXF files directly from Final Cut Pro 10, even if your footage did not originate in MXF. Let's look at how to set this up. From the File menu, choose Share, Add Destination. Drag the compressor settings icon into the destination pane. In the Custom folder, you'll see various MXF delivery options broken down into subfolders. I should also mention that you do not need to have compressor installed to access these MXF presets, or any other custom preset for that matter. You will need compressor, however, if you plan on modifying these presets. Also worth mentioning is that many of these presets export files in the AVC Intra codec, often required by many broadcasters. Let's say I needed a 720p, 50 frames per second, 100 megabit per second file delivered to a broadcast network. I just select the preset, then click OK. I'll then select the clip or project I want to export, then from the Share menu, choose the destination I just added. I'll then click Next and save the file. Final Cut Pro 10 can only export MXF files in the OP1A format, which is basically a self-contained file for delivering and archiving completed MXF projects. What is especially cool about this is that you can edit a show, export it in the OP1A format, upload it to your digital asset management system, then you or someone else can pull it down, import it into Final Cut Pro, and use it as source footage for other projects. No file conversion is necessary. So with this latest Final Cut Pro 10 update and the Pro Video Formats 2.0 update, you have all the tools you need to work with industry standard MXF media.